And welcome everyone. This is the Denver, Colorado stop at the FISE World Series. I am Ryan Meyer and I'm joined with Thomas Friend here. And how are you doing, my man?
Hello, I'm good. We're here in beautiful Denver, Colorado. We're about to start the skateboard semis in a little bit.
So basically, we've come up to this new location. This is the first American stop welcomed all the way overseas here with the FISE series. We had the qualifications, or basically a seeding run, yesterday. And we're about to get into action here. So let's talk a bit about the FISE World Series. We first started off in Montpellier in May, and then we have gone over to Croatia. Now we are here for the third stop on the FISE World Tour here in beautiful Denver, Colorado. We're gonna take a look here, just kind of how it looks, the FISE World Tour. As I was just saying, we started off in France, Montpellier, at the start of May. We moved over to Osijek, Croatia in July. All the way across the pond here, we stand in Denver. And then we're going to be moving at the end of September to Edmonton, Ontario, Canada. And all the way into the end of October to China, Chengdu, China. And that's going to be the five-stop World Series here. And so the series, it's a combination of all action sports disciplines. We have BMX, mountain bike, skateboarding, obviously, which we're here starting. And you've as well worked with FISE many times before in Montpellier. What is your take on the skateboard scene?
Okay, well, this is the second stop this year for Skateboard Pro. We started in Montpellier in May. We didn't go to Osijek, Croatia, but we're here in Denver now for the second stop of the Skateboard FISE World Series. We're gonna go to Edmonton, and the last stop for skateboarding will be in Chengdu, China.
And talking about the course and kind of differences here, in Montpellier, we had two separate courses. The BMX had their park course, and the skateboard had their course. Here, it's all one course. How is that gonna play out for the skaters?
This course behind us is gonna favor some people that can skate everything. It's not only about rails and banks, but we got all the jump boxes, which are made for BMX primarily, but all these people who can use the jump boxes have a big advantage to get more points. So we'll see, this can be a completely different score for people like Beaver Fleming, who, yes, for example, did our course preview 2 days ago.
And I think leading into that, we have that course preview at hand. We're gonna just run through that one right now.
Oh yeah, we got Vincent Melou, which is our defending champion from Montpellier earlier this year in May, and here on the screen you can see what it takes to actually win one of these contests. It's the usage of the park, the amplitude, the style, the speed, and obviously the difficulty of the tricks. Where you see Vincent is using every obstacle in the skate park, going really fast and trying to accumulate all the points, doing flipping tricks, big airs, and down rails. So basically what it takes to win one of these contests is you really have to put everything on the line. You can't really play it safe. And then we actually saw this in Montpellier, where all the finalists skated really well, and no one knew until the end of the finals who is gonna take it. It was, in the end, it was Vincent who really put on a great show.
And I mean, that's some amazing footage as well that we've seen from that street course, basically. And like we were just touching on earlier, this has a lot of different box features, some that are built primarily for the BMX stuff. This course, is it very unique now for skateboarding to have kind of the street and the big box stuff?
Yeah, well, you don't see this very often, so it might be more difficult for some of the riders, as I said. But everyone's been skating the course for the last 3 days. We've had beautiful weather here, so everyone had a lot of practice. So people are getting used to it now. But we see most of the riders are using this one-third of the skate park, and you barely ever see anyone touching the other part. As I said, whenever we see someone skating the other part, that's gonna be where the big points come in.
Okay, and how many people do you think are gonna be using that other part? I mean, you said it's difficult, and obviously I would assume that the judges would score higher if you are using some of those different features?
It's a tough call. I'm not a judge, but whenever someone touches the big ramps, it is high scores. But then, for example, someone skating the bigger rail, the biggest rail in the skate park, that's more dangerous than jumping over the jump box. So how do you put the scores in? Everything has two sides, you know?
Well, that's going to be one for the riders to decide. But I believe Beaver Fleming had kind of a course preview that took us all over the place.
So he has it all.
Let's just check out how he decides to go through the course.
Judges, Austin Teal standing on the other side of the bank ramp in the black tank top.
All right, here we go. Dropping into the big wall. Jumping over the first box. Another step up. Quarter over here. Cruising along this way. Coming over the bank to bank, hitting the quarter pipe. Going into the street section now with the rail, so got this bump to bar. Then we'll come down here into the big rail. There we go. Woo! There we go. Welcome to FISE Denver. It's going to be a good time.
Austin Seahawk, Daniel Cineros.
Bam, and that is how you go through the entire course. Really nice to see a skater go through all the different box jumps and features like that. But if you guys are checking out us online, if you're here even in the crowd or anything like that, check us out on all our social media handles. You can follow us on Facebook and get the official FISE page. It is at FISE.official. You can follow us as well on Twitter and Instagram. The handles are at FISE World. And make sure that you hashtag your posts FISE and hashtag FISE World to get involved with all the action. You can as well follow us on Snapchat. We have a Snapchat handle that is FISE World Series. Make sure that you just get all organized. And that's about it. So walk us through the start list here.
Let's go through the start list. Well, we have 13 best qualifiers from yesterday. We're going to start it off with Austin Seaholm coming from Long Beach, California. Second in will be Daniel Cisneros. Third in from Slovenia, Timotej Lampe Ignic. Then fourth competitor will be Xander Gabriel from Los Angeles, followed by Greg Lutzka, also from California, Julian Christiansen, Dave Baczynski, Beaver Fleming, Richard Turi, all the way from Slovakia, Europe, one of the crowd favorites, Adrian Boulard, Vincent Milou, our defending champion from France, Victor Pellegrin, and last skater in will be Maxime Genin from France.
So a massive international field there, but let's talk a bit about skate format. The judges, how are they gonna, you know, how are they gonna maneuver in this scenario here?
Well, as I mentioned before, our judges, we got three international judges. We got Mark Haziza from France, and Neil Mims, and Willie Santos from United States of America. Then all the judges are looking for the difficulty, speed, amplitude, usage of the skate park, and the overall picture that the rider delivers. So based on this, we're gonna see the scores today. If you guys are watching, you're going to get the general idea in a little bit, because you're going to see the scores in life coming in as the skaters go.
Yeah, and so we've as well, obviously we had a larger qualifying field, and we've now gone into the seeing round. We have 13 skaters. That's going to be broken down into three heats, I believe. One heat with five riders and the other two remaining heats with four riders. And they're going to have two runs each. And I believe it's best run counts,
yes,
isn't it?
That's how we
so
do
you,
it.
So you really have to make your mark, and you know that one run is going to be the counting one here.
It is difficult here to say, like some riders might risk and go all in the first run also, so they want to finish in the top spot to secure themselves a better starting point for tomorrow. But some riders are gonna play it safe and then just finish somewhere in the middle of the starting field for tomorrow. Everyone's got a different tactics for the contest, so you never know what the skate is gonna do.
Yeah, and as well, we're starting in basically reverse seating order. That means that the riders had gone over and competed yesterday in the qualification or seating challenge. And for somebody who doesn't know what that means to start reverse seating order, can you kind of explain that for them?
Yeah, well, we're starting with the skaters who didn't qualify the best, who qualified from as the last qualifier. And that means we're coming into introducing the first qualifiers and people who are going to skate in the first jam, which would be Austin Seaholm, Daniel Cisneros, and Timotej Lampe Ignic, followed by Xander Gabriel and Greg Laska, who's closing the first jam.
And there we have Austin right now. He has some tape on his back. I saw he was at the medical getting a bit wrapped up.
He broke his shoulder. Wow. So it's been a long injury that he's been dealing with. So yeah, Austin has to skate a little safer than usual. This guy has been on the scene for so many years. He's won every major contest around the world, but just name a contest Austin skated in, most likely placed on the podium.
And such a nice guy as well. He mixes in many different disciplines. I see him always having fun with all the different riders here at the FISE.
Yeah, he likes to do the nose manual combos. You see, like, he'd be going in the nose manual, doing one wheel nose manuals and different stunts. I'm just gonna call it a stunt because you don't see this very often.
Yeah.
Austin is amazing. Like, I've seen him all around the world. He's been traveling for 20 years. See all these tricks, like he's using the other part of the skate park, and he's really good at transition, so that's gonna give him some good points.
I mean, and you saying actually that he's been doing this for so long and traveling around the world, skateboarding is pretty much like a democratized sport. It's seen in so many different facets of life, I mean, from fashion to different lifestyle and all different sports sectors. What does that mean for skateboarding? I mean, it's now even like an Olympic sport. How do you guys, like on the core, really see this?
It is, well, it is an amazing opportunity. The fact that we're going towards the Olympics is just gonna open a lot of doors to different skaters. And if someone says they don't like skateboarding in the Olympics, well, it's not gonna change anything. For the people who like to go out and just have fun in the streets, it is gonna stay the same. You're gonna skate with your crew, but then there are some people who wanna go and compete in the Olympics, so this is just gonna open the door. Well, yeah, we just saw Austin's run. It was a really nice one. He didn't go all in. He just played it a little safer. It's one of the runs I was telling you about.
Yeah.
So like he wants to play somewhere in the middle to be sure he makes the cut for tomorrow. But then he obviously threw in some tricks like this feeble grind across that bump to bar.
And speaking about the cut for tomorrow, how many riders are going to qualify from these from this top 13?
We will see 12 riders tomorrow in the finals. That's how we do it. We will break it into three heats of four skaters tomorrow, and again, the format is going to stay the same. We're going to have two rounds, best round count.
Beauty, and as you were saying, we just saw kind of a safety run almost. We could
for Austin, yes, yeah. This was a safety run. Well, he wants to show his skills tomorrow, so he wants to keep the best tricks for tomorrow, obviously. Since this is not a big cut today, the skaters who want to make it just have to put on a show, a little show. You don't have to really try your best. Which means today we're going to see difficult tricks, but we're not going to see anything amazing of what we're going to see tomorrow. Okay, next thing we got Daniel Cisneros, a local skater who joined us for the pro event.
As you say, it's local as well. What does it mean to, I mean, FISE is one of the first publicized events that is doing this worldwide. How is it to have an international event like this come to America now?
It's amazing. A few years ago, I would never imagine FISE is gonna go to North America, but here we are. This is the first stop. We're gonna continue to Edmonton. For these riders, it's something new. Like, you barely ever get to skate contests in the US. You either have to get invited, or there's a bunch of amateur contests, but nothing on this level where you would be actually winning big money like
yes.
You win here in FISE. We got Daniel almost at the end of his run. Oh, that was a scary one.
Ooh, that was close.
He's
close
gonna,
to
he's
the
gonna
rail
try again. He's definitely coming in. Okay, there we go. He's gonna drop in that big quarter. Come for the hippie jump again. Oh!
It's
damn.
You said it's
he's
a
still committed though.
Yeah, you said that hippie jump is.
I do like that. I like the commitment. They're gonna give him one more try. Nah, in second round. Oh, Vern Lert, our on-site announcer wants him to have another try, so we're gonna see.
It's always nice to get the crowd warmed up here.
Yeah, see the crowd's excited here. Everyone wants to see that trick.
You have competed in many contests. A lot with when the crowd gets warmed up like this, does it help you kind of go pull that trick?
Oh, there we go. He gotta be excited. You know, you wanna see the person land his last trick. It's always that nice little ending to the round.
Oh, nice. I was trying to say that when the crowd gets excited for you, does it feel like you can go pull your trick? Does it give you some more confidence?
It always pushes you, yes. Like, you wanna feel the crowd. You wanna feel they are behind you, and they are when they put their hands together, and you feel like they're looking at you and want to see you land your tricks. That's what drives you, and like you wanna do your best. You wanna show the people what you have. Who do we have in for the? So the third rider in would be Timotej Lampe-Ignic. This guy has been traveling the world as well. He's from Slovenia, Europe, and I see him at the biggest contests around the world most of the time. This guy's been a contest veteran. Okay, waiting for the course to clean out. Okay.
De-waxing the rail a bit.
Yeah. Vern started his run, starting in the frontside lip slide down the rail.
Backflip getting away from him.
Now, some people who are not familiar possibly with skateboarding events, does it matter if you crash in your run?
Well, it affects your score. It doesn't matter necessarily because you can just pick up your board and continue where you left off. But it kind of messes with your mind. Yeah. So you have this, you have your run pictured in a certain way, and then when you miss a trick, you just gotta start it again. Oh, cab backflip. That's one of the difficult tricks. One of the favorites now. Like a lot of, I see a lot of people doing cab backflips just recently. Coming for the long rail, the flat bar, feeble grind in the flat bar. That is a long rail. How long is that? That's 20 feet long?
Yeah, this is about 20 feet in the. We're getting to American measurements here.
Yeah.
About 3.5 meters, let's say.
Okay, so well, he still got second round. He missed three of his tricks. He landed about four or five. Usually to make the cut to the finals, that would not be enough. But we're today's not a big cut. As I said, it is a mellow one, so this could be securing his spot for tomorrow. But you never know. He has to put a good show on in the second round. Oh, now all these guys are jumping on the same rail. Oh, they're doing quads.
Trying to create a new sport in itself.
Yeah, right.
If you guys are just joining us online around the world, welcome. This is FISE Denver. This is the third stop of the FISE World Series presented by Honor. FISE has been going on since 1997. Can you believe it? Now it is 2015. We are here. This is the third year of the FISE World Tour, World Series. And can't believe that we're all the way over in Denver, Colorado, the United States of America.
That is amazing. We're starting the 20th year next year.
Yeah, absolutely insane that this amazing action sports festival has been going on for so long. And just gonna take a moment actually to thank Honor. It's one of our global sponsors here at the FISE World Series. It's following us on all of the stops around the tour, and as well, this couldn't happen here in this lovely city without the help of Denver City itself.
Visit Denver, that's what we're thanking to. We got Xander Gabriel coming from Los Angeles, just missing that back tail on the big rail. Xander picking up his board again. Coming in, see, like most of these skaters are using that one line in the skate park.
Yes.
Which is back-to-back handrails, back over crooks on the bump to rail. Making a little U-turn. And going for that long flat bar. Oh, missing the feeble grind. He does this trick every single time.
That must be tough when you have something so locked in your bag and just miss it in your run.
Oh, front chop. See, he was trying to hard flip. That's a completely different trick. He just landed. He still pulled it though. Using the other side of the park. Yeah, he's playing it smart. He knows that's where the points are. It is not easy to deal with the amplitude here, with the altitude here in Denver. We're in a mile high city, right?
Exactly. I mean, I believe we're 5,280 feet to be example, about 1,600 meters. That's why it's nicknamed the Mile High City.
All these riders gotta stay hydrated. It is tough. Yesterday, after the, because yesterday was the format was a little different. It was a 3-minute jam for all the for three riders at the same time. So after the 3 minutes, you just have to keep skating. You can't really breathe in.
It's
so
very hard.
It is. Like I've seen these riders here trying to catch breath. It was difficult. Okay, we're to the replays. There you go. That was supposed to be the hard flip. You see how excited he is? He still pulled it. Coming in for the fake, he knows, but he missed his truck, still came back in. So he did two tricks in his round that were not meant to be the tricks. That is amazing. I'd give him good points for that.
And so you said these riders all have basically planned out their entire run. They know how long they're going to be on course. They know what they're able to do.
Well, yeah, yes and no. I've been skating big contests around the world for 20 years, and I always used to plan my round. I know what I want to do.
Yes.
But at some point, everything changed. I don't like to plan it anymore. I just like to freestyle and go. Whatever comes my way, I'll just do a trick. So some of these riders, I'd say there's Victor Pellegrin, one of our winners in 2015, one of the winners of the tour. He never plans his round. So you never know what to expect from Victor, and that's what makes the show more interesting. So we got one of our stars, Greg Lotzka, who's about to drop in. Greg is a contest veteran. He's really, this guy is probably the most famous skater we have here in the Skateboard Pro event. Starting it off with front 2-7 lip. Going for the rail down back lip, and then using that big quarter pipe on the end, big front 180, and attacking over the high jump. See, Greg knows that's a front board. He knows he doesn't have to go hard because all his tricks are very difficult. So if he just puts them together, he's guaranteed a really good spot in the finals. Back 5-0, that's the long one.
There's a lot of flow as he pumps across the course here.
Front 3, Greg is known for his frontside 360. He can do it in to every trick he wants. Half cap, and coming into the big section to make sure he gets the points for the other side of the park. Back 180, the little quarter, and frontside 360 on the other side. You see, it's a flawless run.
Yep.
Well, Greg is one of the guys who has his runs planned out. You can tell he knows where to push, how fast to go, and what to do. This is a well-planned run.
Well-planned run. That was so flawlessly executed.
First perfect run of the day by Mr. Greg Lotzka himself.
And speaking of perfect, the score is out of 100. So how high do you think judges are going to be going up here?
We will definitely see Greg on the top. And I don't know if we see the scores right now. I think we will reveal the scores after these guys have the second rounds. So for now, in my opinion, Greg's definitely going to be sitting in first. And then either Xander or Timotei, probably sitting in second.
So I believe these are... Is this highlights from Greg's run or from the heat, I believe?
Okay. As far as I hear, we got Greg in first, Austin in second, and Xander in third so far. Oh, there we go. We got the scores on the screen.
After run one, we have Greg with an 89.33. So pushing almost into the 90s there.
That's a very high score. That is a very high score. You see Greg is so obviously. This is going to be a hard score to beat. So as we said, there was a big difference in the scores between the first, second, and third. Greg with a 12-point difference over Austin. Okay, we're back. We're back to the riders and have Austin Seahol in, missing a frontside flip over the bump to rail. That is an unusual way of skating this obstacle. Everyone skates the rail. I've not seen anyone skating over the rail the entire week. Ollie Nord into the Euro gap to a feeble back 5-0, across the long rail.
Such determination from the skaters, even being injured and coming out.
Whoa. You see that nose man all the way.
Such good balance.
And using. Oh, I see that one wheelie nose manny. Getting his tricks, getting the combos down.
Yeah, very technical combinations.
Watching Austin skate feels like playing Skate 3. Right? It's like never-ending combos. Okay, that frontside flip is here.
That was about as much addiction to skateboarding as I had. It was one of the only video games.
And an old slide big spin down the big ledge. That is not an easy trick. That's a lot of risk. You see Austin barely making it through that heat. What is it? We gotta be in the 80s, like high 80s.
Oh, and killing it in the sun here, man. You're just talking about the altitude, but the heat as well. It is pushing 30 degrees Celsius over here. I don't exactly know at all what that is in Fahrenheit.
That was the replay of the feeble to backside 5-0. And straight into the nose manny. Up the Euro gap. See all the balance he has. He could go. He could go for a kilometer.
I saw him do this in practice like 5 times over. He has it completely dialed.
He's been doing that trick for 20 years.
I love those replays. You see
he's stoked. He knows he made the cut, most likely. But it's a little cut, and he knows he did well. So that most likely puts him somewhere in a safe position.
How did you start out riding skate contests?
Oh, wow, that's a good question. I honestly do not remember how I started skating in skate contests, but I remember how I started skateboarding. I used to swim. I used to be a competitive swimmer, yeah. But I had a bad injury. And then I was too lazy to go back to swimming. And after having a cast on my leg for 7 months, I started skating because I saw a crew of skaters behind my house, the apartment building where I used to live with my parents. I just saw these dudes hanging around, having a good time, playing with their skateboards. That was what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. And here we are, 20 years later, I'm in Denver skating,
amazing,
having a great time.
Absolutely amazing. You've made this lifestyle and this choice, and you're all the way out here
doing
what you love. So kids, if you're out there playing Skate 3, maybe take some word of advice here. Get out and skate. For real. So we're just waiting on the next
heat. We got our second skater in. Who's Daniel Cisneros, a local skater. We saw him doing the big hippie jump at the end of his run. I want to see him do it in the middle of the run and then show us something amazing for the end again.
Daniel Cisneros is a local boy here in Denver.
Yeah, getting some speed for the longboard slide. Oh! He's taking some gnarly slams.
He is.
See the commitment? He wants to make the cut.
Full commitment, but tough on the body.
Yes, he's not one of the youngest, so... a lot of respect for people who keep skating, and then especially when they still compete on a skateboard. That is amazing. He's in front of his home crowd also.
We noticed some some people waxing some of the rails, some people taking wax off of the rails. What do you really need? Do you need different for when you're doing board slides versus stuff on your trucks?
It is up to everyone. Usually Brazilians are known for overwaxing every rail and every ledge, and then you'd have people in the States don't wax too much, so it is always different and difficult to say. Some people, oh wow, he touched the rail with his back foot. Yeah, back to the waxing. Some people like it, some people hate it, and it's a half and half, so you can't really call.
This all basically comes down to personal preference, I guess,
yes,
as well.
Yes, exactly.
Kind of how you learn to do things.
Then usually bowl riders wouldn't wax the rail, so if you waxed a bowl, that's a no-no. You never do that. You never wax a culprit.
Don't be afraid to put your hands together, make some noise, man. Only gets the crowd.
Yeah, put your hands together for a local Daniel Cisneros.
The tricks they're going to do. Keep some psych, keep some all motivated.
That was this round. And next skater in, we'll have Timotej Lampe Ignic from Slovenia. He didn't have the best run in the first round. So let's see how he does.
We're gonna have your current standings here. Lutzka sitting on top currently with that 89.33. Siom with the 83 even.
And then third place, Xander Gabriel sitting in third. So yeah, we got Timotej Lampe Ignic dropping in, going again for the front lip. Followed up by the backside lip slide.
He
missed it. Yeah, he missed it in the first round, but he has it now. He had 5 minutes to think about his round, so that probably helped him also.
Yeah,
there we go. The big spin front board to fakie. See, he did three tricks in 10 seconds of his round. That's a good start. Frontside 5-0, the big hover.
And then it continues on.
Yeah. Coming in fakie. Going for cab back lip. Oh yeah,
yes.
Doing that cab back lip. Nice. This round is definitely gonna score higher than the first one.
Got 20 seconds left.
Oh, still 20 seconds left.
Yes, a feeble.
Yeah, pop over. He didn't have enough speed to go all the way, so he decided to pop over the rail, which is even more difficult. And a kickflip backboard. Oh yeah, barely saving that trick. I like it. Still committed. Coming for the last trick, which would be a full cap into the bank. Oh wow. You know what? This could be very close to Greg's run, if not better. But wow, that'd be a big call. If he gets in the 90s, that would be a very high score.
Wow, that was solid right out of the gate.
I'm definitely calling a score close to Greg. Well, let's see how our judges saw
it. It all shaped up on that second rail.
See, he didn't use the other side of the park. He kept going back and forth on the rails. He is a street skater, so we'll see how the judges think. If they think this is worth a score higher than Greg, who was skating mellow, didn't do his best tricks, but still managed to land everything, but skated the other side of the park compared to Timotej, who tried his best. This is probably one of the best runs you will see from Timotej. This is like the best tricks he does. So this, for Timotej, this would be a good thing to know for tomorrow, if his tricks are good enough to place somewhere in the top places.
And that is a way, exactly, that you can kind of weigh your scores with the judges and see what they are liking, what they're not. It is judged event, of course, so you have to base on sometimes a very judgmental opinion, see what the judges are liking, how you're going to be ranked. So Gabriel Zander,
next
from the USA, is going to be next in, currently sitting in fourth place there.
From Los Angeles, California, starting in with a frontside nose grind down the rail, followed by the back tail. Again, he missed this in the first round. He has it now. You see, these riders are getting used to the rounds, getting used to all the stuff. Backside over crooks on the bump to rail. And then the Eurogap ollie in. A crooked grind across the long rail. Getting speed for the Eurogap. Oh yeah, getting the hard flip now. That was, this run is good. This run is way better than the first one.
Both dropping all these, all the these riders the seem to be shaping up a lot more for their second runs here.
Yeah, they're putting it together now.
Got the butterflies.
Wow, yeah.
Out of the way, the bugs all washed off.
Right. 10 seconds to go. Zander's coming in for the big rail. Oh, huge backsmith. Just getting away from him, but he's gonna get another try. Okay, one more try. This is after time, but Sander's going for the backsmith. And oh, yes, Sander. After time backsmith, the biggest rail. This is a 12-stair rail. This is this one is no joke. This is difficult to skate. Wow.
How many years ago would 12-stair have been?
That'd be the best trick in the contest. Not even long ago, like skateboarding is going through some crazy times. Like you see kids posting stuff on Instagram which you would not believe would happen. 5 years ago, if someone told you someone's gonna do this and put on Instagram or whatever social media site, you would laugh in his face. So I really want to see the scores when they come in, because all these all the runs in the second run were amazing. There we have the replay of the backsmith of Zander.
Locked in.
See,
good.
Easy.
Right now, Mike proud.
Oh, he is. Yeah, he is. Though he knows he did really well.
Definitely not an easy one. I wonder what that GoPro angle looks like.
All the kids, the dabs.
Up on the rim. Yeah. I'm sure that's like
to throw in the dab.
But I haven't seen many riders making it fully over to the box sections. A lot of riders seem to be staying all the way over here on the street. And we were having a bit of a debate before whether whether we call this street, whether we call it park. You said, I mean, the discipline basically is
skateboard street.
Skateboard street.
But we're in the skate park, so whatever we call it, people will understand. Okay, we got our current leader dropping in from the other side of the park. Front 270, oh, front 270, nose block. Wow, that's a big start to the round.
Wow.
Backflip down the rail, using the big quarter pipe for front 180 to get speed. That tuck knee we saw in the first round. Big spin front board to fakie. Wow, Greg is stepping it up. How many more points can he get?
Our current leader, he wants to bust into the 90s.
Oh yeah, he wants. He wants to secure the spot. Get the advantage of skating last tomorrow. Backside 5-0 cross. And still 20 seconds to go. Getting that front three. We have not seen Greg miss a single trick yet.
Absolutely amazing. It looks like he's having a bit of fatigue.
Yeah, you know what? I see him having cramps every other contest we go to. He needs to drink more water, but yeah, as we said, that might be the altitude here. Oh, front top flip to end the run.
Had to get one last banger in there.
That was five bangers in this run, not one.
Whew.
Okay, I want to see the scores now when they come in. What do you think? Who do you see in first?
I still see Greg in first. I think he had such flawless and such, you know, his landings were, to me, very, very clean, very collected.
It is for, he's been a professional skateboarder for a reason. We got replays of Greg coming in, starting with the front 270 nosebound. This is one of the tricks not too many people can do. Greg is known, this could be a signature trick.
And you're saying such a difficult trick and the first out of the gates. That's something really big for the judges as well.
He has it on lock. Don't get me wrong. Greg is known for this trick and it is his go-to. Even though no one else can do it, for some reason Greg mastered the trick to the point where he can do it whenever he wants. Okay, we just saw the replays of Greg's run. So we saw two flawless runs from Greg. You know the good thing? So we got the standings after heat one. Greg Lutzka sitting in first, Austin Seaholm in second, Timotej Lampegnič in third, Xander in fourth, and Daniel Cisneros sitting in fifth place.
Oh man, that's it. That was your warm up. Your two nose grinds, Julian, that's it.
So we will have a little warm up for heat two, which will be next, our next four riders, starting with Julian Christiansen from Denver, Colorado, a local skater, followed by Dave Baczynski, Beaver Fleming, and Richard Turi from all the way from Europe, Slovakia.
Beaver was the one who did the beautiful course preview for us earlier.
Julian's going to start
with
the other side.
And Heat 2 is going to be coming up next. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned. We have the BMX semifinals as well later tonight. So stay tuned at 8:30 p.m. Freestyle BMX with UCI here at the FISE World Series.
No more warm-up.
So as the skaters are getting ready here, and the crowd is excited.
There might be a little bit more
down here, beautiful grass area of Denver. We're gonna get started with our heat number two.
I'll let you know when I can send you.
No, we're gonna be going with Julian Christiansen, Dave Baczynski, Beaver Fleming, and Richard Turi.
We're about to see some amazing runs again. All these riders here are contest veterans as well. Julian Christiansen is known for skating all the amateur contests around the States. And we have him dropping in. Speaking of Julian, there we go. He's gonna start from the other side. Nollie back 180 in the quarterfinal.
Is this, this is still warm.
Okay.
We're just hearing.
Sorry for that.
Hearing backwards. This is not his run. This is just still warm up for heat two here. And here it's starting. Actually, Julian's run is going to be starting here.
Oh, switch blunt down the big rail. So that's a way to start the round. Getting some speed for the bump to bar. Nollie nose slide big spin. I like how Julian's rocking the MSA hat. Whoa, Nollie nose grind. That's a difficult one to do. That balance you have to have.
Some punctuation out of these tricks.
Yeah. Nollie front bar. Oh. Not having enough speed. That's a difficult obstacle to have the speed for. If you want to do a trick on the other side on the in the transition in the quarter pipe, you barely get enough speed to skate the bump to bar. Doing a nollie 50-50 across the ledge. Trying to get speed, coming back for the same ledge. Nollie back on off, missing that one. So you can have all these tricks on lock, but when it comes to the contest, it doesn't have to work all the time. Yeah. I like that smile. He's still having a good time.
That's what it's about. It's skating after all.
Same skating and BMX is all the same. People are doing it to have a good time.
All the action sports here at the FISE. So if you guys just tuning in again, this is the FISE World Series presented by Honor. If you don't know what the FISE World Series is, it's basically a worldwide extreme sports tour with some of the best international athletes, including many different disciplines, BMX, mountain bike, inline, wakeboard, and here we are at the skateboard. So we're at the semifinals in skateboard in Denver, Colorado, third stop of the FISE World Series. You want to stay connected with us, make sure you follow us on Facebook. You can search us and like the official FISE.official Facebook page. As well, you can find us on Twitter and Instagram at Facebook, at, sorry, FISE World. Make sure you hashtag your post as well, hashtag FISE and hashtag FISE World to stay in with all the action. As well, you can link us in Snapchat. Make sure you follow the feed, FISE World Series. Stay tuned with all the quick snaps. As well, you can join us at FISE.tv if you're not already there. Be able to catch all the video action. Stay in tune with us every day here at FISE.
Our second rider in would be Dave Baczynski. One of our big pros getting on the other side of the park.
One of the only riders so far that we've seen hit that feature.
Yeah, right? Frontside flip disaster on that quarter pipe.
Both ways.
Oh. He's having a good time.
Showing his own creativity on the course here.
He does. He's really good at both skating street and mini ramps and balls. So we can see some amazing stuff. Oh, that kickflip getting away from him. I don't see that happen too often. And some speed for the down rail, front 2-7 and lip. And another rail with the front board down the big one. Trying to get speed coming all the way up. You see these skaters have to push hard to get speed to hit that one. They've taken speed. Oh, that was a big gap into the quarter pipe. That's the first time I've seen someone skate that.
Jumping over the channel there.
Front blind kickflip, wow. Speaking of best tricks, this would be a contest best trick for any other skater besides of Dave. Like, I have never seen anyone else do this trick. He can just do it like nothing. You know, Dave Baczynski is the person, the only person who ever kickflipped El Toro, the famous 20 stairs.
Wow.
This is how he left the mark on the global
ring. That was huge online.
Okay.
If you guys haven't checked that video, make sure you check it out.
We got a close up on Dave. He's smiling. He's stoked on that front one kickflip.
Dave had an amazing way of utilizing all the course
in.
Here.
That is the front top flip disaster. One of the difficult tricks. And the front 2-7 lip slide down the rail. Super clean. And that front board down. This is difficult to do all these tricks
one-handed, and that huge gap.
Yeah, there we go. I saw people skating on the BMX. Like, how do you skate it on a skateboard?
Yeah.
And the front blanc kickflip. See, that is so difficult to do.
I think that would be my favorite trick.
Oh, that would be my favorite trick if I would ever do it.
I always loved frontside nose blind. I thought that was one of the nicest looking tricks.
Yeah, I like it too. I can do it in quarter pipes. I can do them on rails, but doing them on quarter pipes, it's a good feeling for sure.
These guys are definitely not used to it. That advantage will only play to Julian right here. So next skater.
And so next skater up, we have Beaver Fleming.
That's our course preview guy. See, Beaver's wearing a helmet. He always skates in a helmet. He's part of the Nitro Circus, you know that?
Hey!
That's some big air time.
Wow.
He's taking some speed. He's got no time to lose.
Some huge air, and as you said,
Beaver
Fleming is part of the Nitro Circus crew.
You know, this is a similar line to what he had for the course preview.
Maybe he was putting
in some line
extra.
There you go, back lip on the rail. Speed to go up.
30 seconds to go. Really one of the riders Dropping utilizing
the big, one.
The big, big features here.
Ah, huge transfer, Indy. Oh, missing that one. He uses the course totally different to everyone else.
Completely different.
It is so nice. Oh, that was hard. So he's smiling. I like that. He's got 10 more seconds. We're going to see a big air from him. Yeah, this is our Nitro Circus guy. Back three over the first. Oh! backflip. Did you see that?
Wow, just missing the board
there. That was a backflip attempt. We're going to see it in the second round for sure.
Beaver Fleming, everyone, getting the Colorado crowd stoked here. Charging the course in a complete different way than the other riders here today.
We're about to see the replays of Beaver's run in a second. Just wait for them. Let's see some of the tricks. Let's see some of the tricks he did. Okay, there we go. Starting it off with a big air on the jump box and that back 3-1 foot. Follow up and then that huge transfer he did, the huge transfer in the.
So far down on the transition as well.
And another back three coming in for that backflip he tried. I want to see him do it in the second round. That'd be entertaining.
Yeah, he just missed the grab there.
There you go. He's always smiling. This guy always smiles. Do you know he lives in Woodward? He lives in a practice ground.
In Woodward West?
Woodward West, yeah.
Yeah, it has to be California.
He's been living in Woodward for 3 years. That is amazing. The only other person who lived in Woodward would be Daniel Dares. So you see, like, the camp's bringing up the best skaters.
Definitely, if you're able to skate in and day in and day out like that, it must help.
Especially have the keys to all the skate parks. That's like a paradise, a dream come true for other people.
That was an absolute dream, man. I remember when there was all the video games and Woodward would be in it. We always try and unlock the extra doors.
We got my boy Risho Turin in the skate park doing a nollie board slide on the first rail, kickflip front board on the big down rail. Risho is a flip-in machine. Oh, kickflip backflip.
Oh, like butter, man.
All the three tricks he did are tricks no one else does. Kickflip back 50-50, you never see people flipping in on that big ledge. He does these tricks for breakfast. People grind to backside 5-0, saving it. And then making a U-turn in the big quarter pipe. And skating the big rail. Oh, missing that crooks. Just missing that one. How much time? We got 15 seconds left for Risho. He's gonna go back and try the big rail. 10 seconds in for Risho, so this is gonna be the last trick for him. And whoa! That rail is huge for big spin backside board slide.
Just not holding on the landing.
Missing the two last tricks, but the first five tricks of the run were super difficult, so I want to see, again, I want to see how the judges see the difficulty of the tricks. Because even Greg, who's the current leader, his tricks were not as difficult as Risho's. So he's probably gonna leave it for the round two, try to bump his score up.
So here's some replays.
We got some replays of the kickflip front board, and the kick followed up by the kickflip backflip, super clean.
And so watching this second heat, I feel a lot of we have a lot of differences in the riding throughout this second heat compared to the first one. A lot of differences in line choice and how that all lined up. When you think the scores are coming in with the judges, where are you going to be waiting this second heat versus that first one?
Because we're going to bring in Julian, clear the course.
Okay, we're in the middle of heat two. We just had all our four riders having the first round. And then we're having a little break for the riders to breathe in, and we're gonna be coming to the second round. So wait, we got Julian Christensen dropping in again for his second round with front 270 leg on the small rail. Followed up by a switch tail 270, wow! This is a big round.
Starting that off with a bang, run number two here.
Nollie back 270 lip. I do not see this trick very often. That is really nice. Julian's killing it so far. Nollie 5-0 down the big hubba. Yeah, this is a 12-stair hubba. You don't want to do nollie 5-0 down there. Getting some speed for the Euro gap. Oh, doing the Austin Seaholm nose manning. Drop in the bank, and he's in the second park of this part of the skate park. Big transfer coming back to the street section of the park. Getting some speed. Back 180 nose grind up the hover. That's a weird way to skate it, but it's pretty cool. Oh, big sw- switch blunt down the rail. Are you kidding me?
Wow.
Where did that come from?
It's so perfect.
That was a really good run. Wow. Julian putting it together in his second run. That was amazing.
So that was...
That's the way to do it.
That was starting off the second runs of our heat number two here. Julian.
That is a good way.
Let's check out some replays around for Julian right now. Highlight how this went down.
Coming in for that switch tail 270, one of the big tricks in this run. And the nollie back 270 lip. Manny Santiago has to be stoked. That big air on the big side of the skate park. I want to see that switch blunt. There we go. That is a switchback blunt down the big rail. Perfect execution of the trick. I would not want to do that.
That one does pretty well with the judges as
well.
When I said we will only see these guys go safe, I was wrong. this was pretty gnarly. Like, he was definitely all in. He's trying to grab that spot from Greg. I want to see our scores. I wonder what the scores are now.
I'd like to see a bit of a score recap as well.
It was a... yeah, we're back to Dave Baczynski.
Dave Baczynski.
So currently sitting in second place.
I'd be great
okay,
if we could get...
Okay, 270 lip. Lip slide to Seiki. To Fakey, I'm sorry. Oh, front 270 lift 270. That was nice. He's playing it. He knows he's sitting in second, so we might see some cool stuff. And a 5-0 to tail side to Fakey across the ledge. Yeah, Dave has combos for days as well. You should, whoever's not familiar with Dave's skating, you guys need to watch his mini ramp skills. He's done full mini ramp video parts in the past, and that stuff is very next level. You need to see that. Speaking of nose blunts in the quarter pipes, he's the master of them. And a kickflip, getting away from him, the kickflip from Smith stole in the quarter pipe.
See if he gets one more
in. Yeah, we got 5 seconds left today.
A couple seconds.
It's about to be another nose blunt. He does nose blunt and back lever, the opposite way.
I could assume he was going for an addition to that nose blunt. So, either I believe we're going to get some replays or we're going to get some results here.
We should be getting results now.
Get caught up to date.
Got some replays, probably
waiting for our replay team to show us the footage.
Some abstract art you have here in Denver.
Okay.
Here we go. Break in the 90s, 94.33. Oh, this is the overalls.
Okay, we got Greg Lutzka sitting in first, Julian Christiansen sitting in second, Dave Baczynski in third, Austin Seaholm in fourth, Timotej Lampe Ignic in fifth, and Xander Gabriel in sixth place so far.
And we're going to be moving on to Beaver Fleming. Beaver is the only rider dropping in high up there. As we saw in the course preview and in his first run, he is one of the only skaters here riding the big box jump section of the park course here. His jumps are mainly built for the BMX, but he's taking full advantage of it here.
Oh, wow. That's a Beaver signature. And a finger flip across the other one. Self-props. That was self-props after that. That's almost forbidden to do. A big transfer. Oh, how many tricks has he done so far? Beaver grind. Yeah, that's nice to see a grind trick from Beaver.
I guess if you're able to skate
in a
Woodward,
back lip down the rail.
I guess if you're skating at Woodward
so many
every
tricks.
Day, you really define your style.
Kickflip up the Eurogap. So now he has it all. He's done a grind trick. He's done a kickflip trick. He's done all the airs. What else does he have? Okay, we're gonna see some of the action go down now. The big air. You can see the audience. Like, they like it. Yeah.
Yes,
and now he does it.
On that sub there.
It is a perfect run so far.
Oh.
Whoa! That's some quick feet action there. Yeah. Okay, he nice. Just stole TC.
And here he comes.
Hands
back.
Are up.
Let's see if he can do this backflip.
He's going for the backflip for sure. Okay, and... No! Whoa! Whoa! That was almost there. That's some FMX action there. is this still skateboarding?
This is unreal. A completely unique style.
This is freestyle boarding. That is amazing. Yeah. Isn't that Beaver, get it.
Isn't that what it's all about?
Get in speed. I'm in for that. Oh, there we go. There we go.
Perfect.
There we go. Yeah, he's excited. What is that? Oh, wow. It's a little ritual. I don't see that too often. Well, do you see this in BMX or mountain biking?
No.
You don't.
No.
Well, I mean, you don't see this in skateboarding either. Don't get me wrong. Yeah, he is excited.
Wow. Beaver flying. Let's check out some replays. I don't even know what we're going to highlight on. There was a lot out of this run.
We're standing over that big action. What is that, a Superman? I don't even know. That kickflip, finger
flip?
I don't know how to call these tricks. What is going on?
Flip, massive technical.
I need to get Beaver as a specialist here. I have no idea what's going on.
You're supposed to be the expert, my man.
Well, you're probably better than me on this. I don't know what's going on.
I don't know.
It's a jump to a jump.
There's his backside 360 here.
This one was pretty cool, the hands up, Beaver. And that one, wow. I mean, this is motocross.
What is that, like a caveman?
Well, let me think.
What is?
It is a backflip Superman. I don't know. Backflip Superman double grab? I guess. Well, I'm going to ask him. Okay. The last person in this heat, the fourth person of heat two, and round two will be Richard Turi.
Okay, score's in.
Oh, we got Beaver in second with a score of 9-2. Wow, Beaver in place two.
Moved way up, sitting there with a 9-2, even now in second place.
That is
Beaver
big scores. I wouldn't expect the score to be this high,
wow,
but well,
nine,
there we go.
92,
there you see what the judges want to see.
In the middle 90s already, and we haven't even touched the third heat.
That's supposed to be the best skaters because that's our pre-qualified riders who qualified through their success in the previous events or the years. And we got Richard Turi in the park now, starting it off with an ollie board slide down the rail, kickflip from the board on the big rail. This is a super difficult one. Getting speed for the bump to rail and doing a kickflip back lip. The only person who flips into rails all the time. Getting speed for the kickflip backside 50 down the big hover. That's super clean, the execution. Getting a U-turn on the big wall. Ow! Oh! Missing a feeble grind. I want to say his kingpin got stuck on the rail because that slam doesn't happen too often. Like his board stopped grinding. Making a U-turn. Oh, going for the big spin backboard. Still 10 seconds left. Michel leaving his head on the ground. Coming for the redemption of the big rail. And that's the way to end your round.
That's
big spin backboard.
That's what we call redemption
for
here.
Sure. 100%. That issue took a gnarly slam. You know, he broke his wrist a couple months ago and he had a cast on the wrist for 3 months.
Back at it.
Like
with the wrist brace.
4 weeks ago, they took it off and now I saw the slam like he took straight on the wrist. I hope he's okay. He seems to be okay though. We're probably going to see some replays of his round. Okay.
Okay, and to our Facebook audience, actually. We are going to have to reset a couple settings. You're going to be losing your feed just very temporarily. So to everyone out there in the Facebook world, stay tuned with us. And you can refresh your action. It's going to be right back at you. Just momentarily, you're going to be losing a bit of connection with your feed. But for all other social media out there, if you're checking us on Facebook, you can as well check us out on Twitter at FISE World, as well as same at FISE World for our Instagram channel. Make sure to hashtag us FISE and FISE World. But here, let's take a bit of a look at the standings. We have Greg Luska in first place there with that 94.33. Such a massive score already. And we still have one more heat to come. And speaking of that, heat three, here is the start list. Coming at you momentarily. Heat three, we're going to be starting with Maxime Genin.
Maxime is actually the last person to skate. So we're starting the heat off with Adrien Boulard, followed up by Vincent Malou, Victor Pellegrin, and Maxime Genin. Basically, these four riders are the skaters that pre-qualified to the contest through either Montpellier or winning last year's, being the leaders of last year's overall standings.
Vincent Malou as well. I mean, some top, top dogs here.
It's a full-on French crew here.
In the FISE world, this, yes, this is the French invasion.
I'm gonna have to learn how to say that in French.
See, but the first okay, guys you see we got the riders practicing, all our four. We got a camera on Adrien Boulard, one of the crowd's favorite in France. Okay, there he is, that is actually Adrien's run. Backflip down the rail, and a U-turn. Oh, speed check? It's a front block, wow, he had no speed. How did he still pull that?
Yeah, I love this guy's stuff.
Front board. He was gonna do front feeble, but didn't lock the track in. And still did the front board. Front 180 over the big rail. Coming in for a smooth grind 180. Wow. That's some board control right there.
At a very slow speed as well for that.
He's taking his time. He likes those speed checks.
Another speed.
Wow! Tray flipping to the Euro
guard.
Wow! Crooked grind on the flat bar. Popping out early.
Such an amazing rider.
Tray flip, that'd be amazing if he still pulled it. A tray flip onto the, or 1 foot onto the box.
Do something or you can just chill. It's up to you.
I like how our announcer, onside announcer Vern Lurt just told him you can either do something or chill. He just had an amazing run of, he basically chilled all the way through the run, but still pulled amazing tricks.
And his riding style as well, you see him, he's just so absolutely at ease on his skateboard.
This guy's a beast. Do you see that huge wall on the other side, the honor wall?
Yes.
He kickflip and backside flip into the wall. That is deadly.
Wow, and some amazing riding as well. We're gonna have some replays.
Okay, you got Adrien in with a super slow speed from Blanc. And you see the tray flip into the Euro gap. No one skates into the Euro gap. This is difficult.
He catches that with his front foot so beautifully there.
It is a perfect execution of the tray. Who do we have second in this? Okay, second person in this heat would be Vincent Malou. Oh, Vincent's already in with a feeble grind across the bar. Oh yeah, this is Vincent's practice. He's waiting for his turn.
You are the next skater. He's out here warming up and looking at the rails, but just let you know, you are the next skater, so go to a starting position.
So Vincent Malou is just going up to start off his run.
Oh, Vincent's going to be dropping in on the big wall.
They said this is a full French heat. Our second rider of the day starting off above the honor wall. Vincent dropping in to the big box.
This is the big dog. Yeah, Vincent. It's our defending winner from Montpellier. Frontside Smith grind down the big rail. Oh, skating the big wall. Front feet across the long bar. Yeah, definitely going the distance, as our announcer Ben Learn just said. Back tail down the rail. Making some fast, like strong pushes. Gets beat. And kickflip over the hydrant. Another push. And, missing that back over crooks. He does that trick every go.
It must be so difficult to keep your composure throughout all these tricks laid out right after each other.
I mean, it is, but not for guys like Vincent. He's a G, he does it all the time. He skates contests, usually he goes to the contest to make the podium. And I think this is gonna be the case again. Frontside flip up the Euro gap. He's another person coming from a bad injury. He broke his ankle in early July in Germany at a contest.
That's right.
But yeah, you see, him looking at the ankle. He's taking it easy. But still, him taking it easy is one of the best rounds of the day.
I like how he used the entire course. And that's what the judges are looking for. He's no stranger to winning contests. So
okay, there we got
two replays
kick
over
flip.
The rider in there.
And then the front top flip up the Eurogap.
I'm not making that up. All right.
It's funny how our TV production used the two flip tricks, none of the rail tricks, which is the big tricks in his round.
That injury
is painful. He needs to take time. He should go and ice the ankle before tomorrow because he definitely made the cut. He doesn't have to skate the second round.
I love France.
But such amazing riding so far out of the skaters here in this semi-final. It's going to be tough to actually weed out the ones and see who makes it into the final, especially after this third and final heat here.
You ready? Oh, this is like my favorite thing to watch, man.
There we go. We got Victor Pellegrin dropping in another one of the crowd's favorites. Oh, we got Wally into the bank. Nose many across the box. See, Victor is the dude who never plans this round. You will see, like, you will see him just freestyling in the skateboard. You can tell. Oh, the Bennett grind.
Barley grind, as I like to call it, or some people like to call it the Bennett grind.
Victor.
Tray flip into the bang. Followed up with, front flip to Smith. Wow. You gotta be kidding me with that one. That was very nice.
Always has his huge.
Back up flip.
Huge smile on his face.
Yeah, we got him in the big section of the park, using the quarter pipes and coming back to the street course. I like how he just used it for 3 seconds, but made sure he goes there so he gets the points. That's a smart way to do it. Now, Victor's really good at skating quarter pipes, so if he wanted, he could just stay in the other side of the park and just make the cut as well. Oh, look at the style. See the difference between the street skater skating the jump boxes compared to Beaver,
exactly.
Who is a vert skater.
Yes.
Like, you can tell, like, right away what the people skate.
And so do the judges actually score that higher if a street skater?
I would, because I skate street and I like the mellow style that Victor has. So you can see he's skating loose trucks, big bore, so he's skating a lot of bowls. But he skates a lot of street too. Yeah, boy. That was one of my favorite runs so far.
Starting off there with that little Wally.
Yeah, we got the Wally into the bank. Followed up with that nose Manny. Oh, we cut the nose Manny, but there we go. The Bennett grind.
I might have to kidnap you, make you come to L.
And doing the front lip to front Smith. You don't see this too often. The combos on the rail. Look at the style.
So,
boom!
So hard, I would imagine, to get back onto your
I like the end of the little take he did. That's my favorite. Even though it's not a trick, it's my favorite thing. Like, you know, sometimes you see something super cool and steezy, like that's the favorite thing that stands out. This is the thing that stands out.
It's kind of like a shifty on some or something.
Yeah.
I love watching you skate. Next skater, and it'll be
so
the last of
we
the
have
guys,
one
go
rider left here.
Definitely no stranger. I've seen this guy in contests all over the world, Tampa, you name it. All
rider
those
left
high,
of the semifinals and our last rider
really
as well for heat number three.
This is the last rider of heat three, and he's gonna be closing the semis as well on when they come to heat to the second round. So yeah, we will have Maxime Genon dropping in a second. Still got the camera showing us the overview of the park with nice sculptures in the background. And there we go, Maxime's in, starting it off with a big rail, front lip. That is a big rail to start with. Front 180, the quarter pipe into the wall. Oh, that three shot missing that one. Getting back on the board, dropping in fakey flip into the bank, and a switch feeble. Whoa! I don't see people do that trick too often either. Kickflip backflip on the rail. You can see he's been skating a lot of contests, right? Like he has it all planned and nice, like ready for the round. People grind on the fly bar.
Ooh. That is a really long rail.
It is, yeah. You gotta hold it, you just gotta go the distance. Oh! Missing the full cap flip up the Euro gap. He's the only person doing going faking up the Euro gap. That is not easy. Oh, that big air. Finishing it off with a big air. I like the round. I liked it. That was a nice one. Max is no stranger to winning FISE. He's won FISE events before, and he is one of our overall winners of 2016 of the FISE World Series presented by Honor. Best run
counts. So let's just check some replays from Max's run here.
That is the switch feeble I was talking about earlier. Coming in for the kick, flip, back lip. Perfect execution on the bump to rail. This is a favorite trick of most of the skaters to do the feeble grind on that flip bar.
Adrian, just to let you know, you are next. Down there on
so
the
second rider in. We will have. Oh, we're coming. Sorry, we're coming back to the top of the order.
Going back to Adrian Boulard, I believe.
Adrian Boulard
dropping in now for his second final attempt here at the semis.
Yep, he just arrived to the park. He's waiting for the announcer to start the timer for him, the clock.
Makes it look real easy. We got some results up there on the Jumbotron.
Okay,
you
see our results here. Oh, we missed the first six, but we got, oh yeah, we got Greg Lotzka still sitting in first. Beaver Fleming in second, right, Julian Christensen in third, Dave Paczynski in fourth, Austin Seaholm in fifth, and Vincent right Milou in sixth with a score of 81.66.
Wow. What is that, wax?
None of our defending champions are in the top five.
That's amazing.
That's showing us how high the level for tomorrow's finals is going to be.
They're really trying to step it up and show that they got game for tomorrow's finals. Other Frenchies are just, you know, chilling out, having a good time here.
They are having a good time. Oh, Adrian Boulard should be dropping in. He's ranked 12. He is 12. Okay, dropping in, doing a frontside 5-0 on the rail. Back lip down the second rail in the row, the bigger one of them. Big tray flick, big old tray. From Feeble, now not missing the backtrack.
I think he's feeling the heat, saw that he was in 12 there.
Yes, he's definitely stepping it up. Well, I mean, he skated well in the first round too. Nolly heel. This guy, yeah, this guy can do it all. Back lip, oh, whoa. This is almost a contest, mate. Contest, mate. When you stay on the board and stay on it for at least 5 meters, I'd consider this a contest, mate.
And what do you mean by contest, mate?
Oh, whoa! You saw the tray flip 50-50 holding on to it. He barely locked the trucks in, so just holding on. Big flip on board, missing that one. By a contest, mate. Sorry, let's get back to it. When you skate in street, filming for a video or shooting photos for a magazine, you have to do the trick and you have to land it and have a clean landing to be considered a make.
Yes.
While in the contest, you can touch on the ground. You can, if you don't do it perfect, sometimes you land it sketchy or like you step off after a few meters. That's called a contest make. You don't get the same points as if you would have done it perfectly, but you still get some points awarded. That's a contest make.
So note that.
Oh, that was a nice way of landing the big flip from board.
Is that a contest make as well?
I would say it is, for 0.2 points.
So let's just check some replays at Adrian Boulard's run here.
That beautiful tray flip.
Massive.
You can see the two announcers in the background giving props to them. And we'll see the tray flip. Look at the truck. That's what I was talking about.
Wow.
Well, if it wasn't to Adrian, I'd say everyone else would just like kick the trick, kick the board away. But not this guy. Definitely not this guy. He's landing everything.
I was excited just watching Adrian put on a demo basically after the run. You know, it's okay. We're ready. We're gonna bring in
That was a good round. I liked it. It's always saying, refreshing to watch Adrian skate.
We were just saying off screen, Adrian was putting basically a demo together.
But yeah, we got Vincent Malou back in.
Vincent Malou.
For his second round. He was ranked 8. That is very low. On the leaderboard. Oh, that backsmith was beautiful.
Again, we have 13.
Yeah, Vincent.
We have 13 riders here, and how many are qualifying or making it?
Well,
to the
12 riders are making the cut for tomorrow. So that is basically almost everyone makes it. Big spin from board to fakie. Vincent is one of our youngest riders, and yet one of our best finishing contest skaters. This is, you don't see this very often.
And coming off that ankle injury.
Not even 8 weeks ago.
I don't know if you've ever broken your ankle. I'm assuming.
Multiple times, my friend.
I'm assuming it is not an easy one to get recovered from.
Yeah, it is the mindset you put yourself into. Then, like, it is difficult to start flipping your board again. But Vincent definitely has not the problem we were talking about. From Blunt, the big rail. Oh, I got a feeling we might have a new winner. Actually, not a winner, but our leader. Switchback clip on the bump. Bump to rail, Vincent. That was amazing. That was a perfect round. That last switch heel was after time. Yeah, Vincent. I'm calling a new leader. I'm calling it right here.
Okay, you see if your money was where your mouth is. And we're going to see if we can check out.
Yeah, the hype is there. He's stoked. He's getting props from all the other riders. We come into the replays of his run.
If you would call out something, what was your favorite part of this run?
That was beautiful. Probably the backsmith, actually. I like backsmith. Front top flip. That was probably Vincent's favorite part because after the injury, he said he cannot flip his board. And he can flip, as you see. And switchback lip to finish it off. Yeah, he is excited.
We got.
I did two fins.
Yeah.
What is that? I wanna know what that means. Whoever's watching this and speaks French and English, please let me know. I wanna know what he said.
A couple phrases, I hope. What is that? Good luck, right there.
Okay, we're gonna have our scores coming in a second.
Something about Victor's hair.
Give him some mojo right now. Victor, you're up next, just to let you know.
Oh, okay, almost. Vincent's coming into second place with a score of 93. If it was my call, I would put him in first. But we got our three judges, and this is how they saw it.
Can you imagine that? The top fives are all in the high 80s, if not 90s already.
That is insane.
Absolutely insane.
That doesn't happen too often. Okay, we got Victor Pellegrin. He was ranked 11th. Smith grind, popping. Oh, missing the front Smith.
Still has the biggest smile on his face. Love
always
watching this
smiles.
Guy ride.
You know we're in Colorado and buying herbs here is legal, and this guy is very happy. You can see.
That was crazy.
You know, actually, I read an article that since last year, since the legalization, the population of Denver has raised 100,000.
Has it?
Yes.
Well,
in a town of only 650,000.
We might have a new person moving in. No. He definitely just has a smile on his face because he likes to smile and have a good time. Whenever you look at Victor, he would be throwing in jokes and talking to people, just being a good dude. Yeah, he's like, what should I do? I'm just cruising. He knows he's sitting in 11th, which means he's making the cut anyway, so he's just out there having a good time. Yeah, it's gonna be time for Victor, but he's got one more trick for us. And wow!
My favorite trick.
Yeah, there you go, we got that nose blunt in. It's a big help to do it on. 50-50 kick flip.
This is true freestyling of a run, like you said.
Favorite of mine, a bear, Thomas. High five from above right there. The guys doing the live television broadcast.
He is happy. I like happy people. Right. Thank you, Victor, for being
right
here.
On TV.
That is nice to see him.
TV so I can see what they're saying, man. I know they're doing a great job over there.
What's up with that crusty hair?
Yeah, exactly, man.
Crusty haircut?
It looks like Sideshow Bob.
Okay, we got that nose blunt replay. How beautiful that is. Look at the landing. He's like, no, I'm not letting that go away from me. See, these riders are having a tough time dealing with the heat and the altitude. That's definitely going to be a better score than the first round. Okay, and we will have our last skater in. That Maxime Genon is going to be our last semifinal skater before we move on to BMX in a little bit. So he, three, skater number four, and his second round. Maxime Genon, currently ranked 12th place, dropping in. Starting it off with a frontside lip slide on that big rail. Front 180 on the wall. Oh, missing that three shot up the Euro gap. Coming in fakie. Oh, catch it! Damn, losing his board. There should be someone giving him the board. I guess we're gonna stop the clock. Wait for him to get back up in the skate park.
Wow, one of the few riders who was unable to pull it back together for run two.
Right, it is the heat, like it gotta be the heat because Max has been skating these contests for many, many years. Okay, we're gonna give him some extra time for sure. Nollie heel backlit, I'm sorry. Okay, he's over it. He lost his board, so he's gonna hold on to the score from his first round. Probably finishing 12th, which is still guaranteeing the making the cup. So basically only one person didn't make it today for tomorrow. The 12th will be in the finals tomorrow. Okay, we're gonna have the scores in just a second.
I'm just gonna wait on our three judges here. Mark, Willie, and Noel is just gonna tally up everything. If you're wanting to stay connected, remember, you guys are rejoining us back on the Facebook.
Okay, there we go. We got the scores in. We got Greg Lutzka sitting in first with a score of 94.33, followed up by Vincent Milou, Beaver Fleming in third, Julian Christensen in fourth, fifth place Dave Paczynski, sixth place finisher Austin Seaholm, seventh Adrian Blore, eighth Timotej Lampe Ignic, ninth Xander Gabriel, 10th place Richard Turi with a score of 78. 11th in Victor Pellegrin, 12th Maxime Genon, and 13th, not making the cut, is Daniel Cisternos.
So Daniel from our first heat there, he is our one who is not going to be making the cut, but social media boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, if you're joining us here, FISE, follow us, the official FISE page, it's FISE.official on Facebook and Twitter, you can check us out, FISE World, and Instagram, FISE World, make sure you hashtag FISE and hashtag FISE World, as well Snapchat, FISE World Series, but if you want to follow myself, or Thomas, you can both find us on Instagram. And, Thomas Vinter, and myself, Ryan Meyer. As well, stay tuned. We are going to be having the BMX semifinals coming right at you at 8:30, I believe, tonight. But if you are joining us as well for the World Series, please make sure that you know what's happening next. It is going to be Edmonton, Canada. That's where we're headed next with the FISE World Series. And welcome back here to Denver. The sun is setting. It's still so hot out. We're going to wait for it to just cool off a tiny bit. So what did you think of the skate contest here?
It was absolutely amazing. Like we saw our international field of skaters putting it down. We ended up seeing one of our favorites, Greg Lutzka, taking the first spot. And we will see the top 12 finishers for tomorrow's finals. What time do we have the finals tomorrow?
Yeah, the finals are going to be at 3:30. So make sure you check us back here, FISE.tv. You can watch us internationally. And that's going to be for the finals tomorrow. But today we still have action. We have the BMX semifinals, and that's going to be happening at 8:30 today. So please stay tuned. FISE.tv, check us out here. If you're in the Denver area, come down. It is a free event for public. You can come down here and check it out yourself. But if not, stay connected with our social media. We've hit you out, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat. But if you want all the action, the live stuff, FISE.tv, that's where you're going to find us.
I got to say, I'm doing the FISE Snapchat for today. So make sure you follow FISE Snapchat at FISE World Series. Check the action live.
And on behalf of Thomas and myself, we'll see you later today, 8:30 for BMX semifinals.
Thank you, everyone.